Are you going to actually lay down?
Catherine McIntyre gave birth to Rose Taylor 6 weeks ago.
And she likes floor time.
She delivered Rose at Feather River Hospital in Paradise just 3 weeks before the campfire.
It was really scary to think of that, to think we were just there.
Rose is now the youngest of four kids. So Catherine's got her hands full, but now an added worry after they have all spent time in heavy smoke from wildfires.
You never know what you're breathing in. Anything that you eat, anything that you breathe, that goes to the children.
She was 6 months pregnant with Rose during the car fire this summer, so she had concerns.
Birth defects, lifelong effects, complications during the birthing, or if it's going to cause a miscarriage or a stillborn. A stillborn would be one of my biggest fears, or death afterwards.
Those are fears that Dr. Rebecca Schmidt and her team at UC Davis are trying to address.
There's exposures to things like melted plastics and any kind of chemicals that were in building materials, and those are the things we don't really know what effects those might have.
Researchers collected samples from more than 200 moms and their babies, including hair, blood, placentas, and breast milk. And they asked questions about what moms did to protect themselves.
Maybe we'll shed some light on whether those masks are doing anything too. You know, something that can help prepare moms for the next fire.
As for baby Rose, her mom says she's doing okay.
She has some problems breathing on occasion, but not something that I think is too worrisome.
But the wildfires are smoking them out. They now plan to leave the state for good.
California has been on fire since we moved back. It's been terrible.